billion-dollar businesses. One is for RMIT, another one is for One New Medical Corporation. And I think that every human needs three things. It's about a job and a career. So in a job and career, I'm a CIO, Chief Information Officer. And I think that the third thing a human needs is a passion. And that was my calling. And that was my calling, which is VSHR, which is a nonprofit organization. And we are actually meeting up through this nonprofit organization today as well, too. So what I have done I think my key passion is this one. I like to work with large companies, solving their problem and empowering them so they can achieve more bigger goals on the way, on the journey. So that's the core statement I drive my career. I have been speaking to 165 workshops, conferences last few years. I online, offline, digital platform, I train around 13 to 15,000 people so far, mostly professionals. So now let's talk about the personal branding. Let's talk about talking about me. I think it's more valuable right now. So we know that when you want to accomplish something, you know, in life, like if we want to go from point A to point B, what do we need most? We need to have a strategy, right? So we can go there based on our resource, the time, and also based on probably the most possible way we can pick that up as well too. So that's the strategy part, right? But the strategy is the strategy, which is important, but what it matters most is also the second part, which is the execution. Because without the execution, a strategy is just a piece of paper or just an idea just dying in the brain, right? So when you talk about the personal branding, it needs these two things as well too. It needs a strategy, and it needs an execution as well too. Because without a strategy, you will not have an execution, and at the same time, if you don't do execution, it's just a piece of paper or just a bit of idea, like every time it popped up when we had a coffee with some friends and so on. So now I want to talk about this. I want to ask you a few questions. How many of you made two posts in LinkedIn last 1 week of time? Please raise your hand. You got, all right, four, five, one. All right, so you can see that there's a few hands raised up, but 50% of you have not. The second question I want to ask you, how many of you made two posts in Facebook last 1 week of time? Hang on, I haven't finished yet. Which is related to your action, vision, and mission, not a baby face or not a banana face or something you're doing in your window of time. Please raise your hand. All right, it's actually lower. People actually push more in LinkedIn. The last one is how many of you actually made one video post in YouTube in last 4 weeks of time? Please raise your hand. All right, so you got three of them, okay. So you can see this one. There's a lot of hands jump in, up, and a lot of hand was down. So you can see this one is about this platform is where is we can build a personal brand. Because we have been living in 2020 and we have been so much lucky compared to our father or even our grandparents, because to build a personal brand, the only channel they had is about going to newspaper and pay them to put something in a newspaper, or go to the TV and pay them pretty hefty cost per minutes of prices and put a video, and they have no idea actually how many people are actually seeing it to it. And now we're living in this era and we have this kinds of platform which can help us to build a personal brand, and we're not still doing it, right? We know that it's so much
but there are a lot of people that is doing putting not well content.
Exactly. So this is exactly.
In fact, the great majority of people is doing things that, in fact, of creating a positive brand, is creating a negative one.
Exactly. When you start doing something, it's matter, but you need to do it right as well too. Yeah. So this is something I'm gonna cover as well in the talk. So when you want to talk about a personal brand, like what we just Pedro just mentioned about not doing it right, because they're not talking about the stories. They're not talking about the mission, vision, or action. They're putting content which has no value for the people who are actually looking into it. So the quality of the content has no value for the viewers. They just simply walk in. Or even the society becomes so interesting people getting a lot of posts because like, share, and comments as well too. And that's why I think about the content which is gonna get almost like and views from the friend in Facebook, that makes sense, but actually it's not. So we have to have a proper content which actually align to our mission, vision, and action. If you're not aligning our posts or content, not aligning any of them, it's just one waste of time. We actually, so unfortunately, we know that like, share, and views and comments doesn't really make sense if we don't put the right content into it. But unfortunately, most of us actually chasing that right now. Yeah. That's the fact.
But you need to think, you should have a purpose to publish something.
Exactly.
Yes.
It can be personal or professional, but you need to have an objective.
If
you
exactly. Exactly. We need to have the right strategy to do that as well too. So even we know that, it's so much important to start on. So let me focus about starting on something and then focus on the right content. So when we want to start on this one, the main reason why you're not really doing it is this, the fear of judgment of others. That's the core inside. One of the reason is, even we know that personal branding is so much important, one of the key reasons we are not doing into it because just skeptical with the fears of judgment of others. We got a great post, you're building something, great product, or you have a vision and you have a statement about something which is you think that you're gonna have value for many other community, and you don't want, many of the people don't wanna post that one because their friends, their colleagues, or maybe their spouses, or their boyfriend or girlfriend will make a sneaky comment into that one, and they don't wanna do it anymore. So that's the core inside of this one, is why we fail to build a personal brand, is we fear of judging others, but unfortunately, most of us, it's inside of this thing. So that's the number one reason, is why we are not starting, even we know that it's so much important to us. So what else? The fear of investing of time. So this is where it's so crucial right now. Now we, all the people are living in an era of instant gratification. Now we can swab and get a date. We are feeling hungry or thirsty, we can simply just book something and get a drink delivered to our way home, which is very different than even like a few years back where we want to have a meal team, we want to get up, we want to dress up, we want to go to a motorbike, and we drive all the way down, and then we think about where do you want to drink, and then we sit down, and then we order, we queue up, and then we get the drink, and then we get a seat and drink, and then we come back all the way. But now, it's that simple. Get there. Spend 1 minute, spend the cash. It's not
just part of the pleasure to do that.
Exactly. So the fear of investing time becomes so much big in our mind because we have been all are into instant gratifications. Now so now what happening right now, many of the people who starting this personal branding and just simply giving up after 3 or 4 weeks later, because no one is commenting, no one is liking, no one is sharing their content, and just simply give up. Because they're thinking that there's no return, but people forget that one. To build something great, we need to invest the time and have to be passionate. So that's why I like to call this one is about macro passions, micro actions. That is matter most, but we are not unfortunately doing it. And we're just giving up. Because look about this, every one of us know that to be a good fit, we need to eat healthy, we have to sleep right, and we have to probably go to the gym few times in a week to the gym to do some reps into it, or probably do some walking every day. But still, we're not doing it. And we're hoping there's a pill which we can pay and take it and get fit and lose our weight. We're not still not doing it. So the fear of investment of time is so much crucial. To build a personal brand, it takes years. Why? The number one reason is in the beginning, first few months, we are absolutely suck at it. Because the content we create is an absolute sucks. People don't see any value into it, and we keep posting some random thing which you have no idea. And even sometimes when we work on a big vision, we have no idea actually what is a big vision actually, but we keep working on it. and keep breaking it down again and again and molding it down, and finally it become more clear to us. So that's why the fear of investment is so much important to us, which actually is stopping us to build our personal brand. So we're talking about the fear. So I want to talk about what is fear. So for me, the life taught me what is the meaning of true fear. The meaning of true fear is about the fake emotion appearing real. It's not happened yet, but we have been thinking about it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Maybe it happened before in the past, but we're still assuming into it. It's going to happen again, and we don't want to take the steps which we want to do. I mean, now we've been living in places like about right now, rather than talking one person, we like to grab the phone and send a message. Rather than talking to the person, now this fear went to that so deep down in our mind. And one of the things we have forgotten is this one. What is the TV we used to watch at home that become the radio, and this one become the TV? Because every one of us holding in our hand or is in our pocket, and probably this is the device we spend almost 24 hours of time as long as we're AOK, is in our pocket or in our hand. Actually, this device is our partner, more important partner than our boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, kids, anything. This device is more spending more time with us than we're spending, and we love watching it. I want to tell you the story. So a few weeks ago, I was in a WC, and then I was looking at the phone, and then I was almost gonna drop this one in the comfort, and you know the panic come to my mind. I'm thinking, wow, I'm gonna drop my phone, and then probably next few weeks I won't have any phone with me, because or maybe 1 or 2 days I won't have phone. The panic of not having the phone, it's so big, because it's actually develops a huge relationship with us.
It's easy. If you leave the home, if you forget something, probably you don't think about coming back. If you don't forget the mobile,
you go back and get it, right? So I tell you that I was dropping in this one in the comment. I've been panicking it out. Oh my god, I will not have any phone. I cannot connect to anyone. I cannot make any posts. I'm not talking to any friends. I will be disconnected from the whole world.
I don't know how to live.
So this is Mattermost. Is we living in these fake emotions, which actually we've been fearful of judgment. We became fearful of our those other people of who's thinking about our boss. So this is another thing which is matter most to me. These two fear is so connected and so much deep dive inside of us and kind of run inside of our mind like an autopilot, which is actually drive us to the next problem, which is the insecurity. And this is the insecurity part actually that kicked on when we finally decided to start building our personal branding. I mean, we already decided, I'm gonna do it anyway, right? And then we just moved on, and this insecurity just kicked on in our mind. And then what do? We start to get into suit, we start to get into a cozy camera, we try to get an expensive camera, we spend a lot of money into it, and wear suits, and which we're not. There's a lot of people who are wearing suits, I mean, for the daily work, and they are into it. But there's a lot of people who does not. And they're getting onto those things, and they're trying to simply pretending to someone else into this personal branding materials. And you know what? The world is full of smart people. And they just simply pick it up. You are not that person in real life and what you do in digital space. And they simply catch it. And you just simply get lost in the very early stage before you start your personal branding thing. So there's a deep dive of insecurity is so bad and actually killing so many effort to become a success, building a successful brand, personal branding. So now the thing is, John, you've been telling a lot of things. How do you stop? Right? I told you that. How do we start? How do we start? To start on something, I want to tell you this one. You may start, okay, where should I start? LinkedIn or YouTube, Facebook,
Twitter? I have a question.
Sure.
Provocative question. How do you start with digital
branding?
Because personal branding is not necessarily digital personal
yep.
branding.
Yeah.
So we need to think about how to start before we have the digital presence.
Sure.
Because you need to create your personal branding, and then you need to create your digital.
Sure.
So I have one more. I didn't get the why. Why should we do the personal branding? Because the thing is, when you said you have to have three things, job, career, and purpose, but many people have not found their purpose yet.
Okay, so let me put in the parking lot. We can get into it.
We are here not to do your life easier.
I understand. It's going to be challenging for me. I'm up on this one too. I'm actually happy you guys are raising Christian. Good. I like that. So I want to tell you what this one is about. Personal branding, you could build in different way, just related to your Christian. You could do all this thing. You can go to the events, and you can do, you can meet people on offline branding. But I'm talking about this one, is this one, the two factor here. If you walk into different events, how many events you can really can walk in every day? Maximum one, and then in after work? And how many you can do, for how many weeks you can do? You burn out. So that's why you need a scale. You need a scale, and you need a proper thing. And that's why the strategy kicked in. Because you don't want to put like 100 hours of offline events, and you can meet only like 50 people. But if you can scoot down in digital space in 10 hours, and you can create a content and which will be there forever for other people to watch, and you can organically reach more and more and more and more and people. So, I mean, if you wanna go and you think that, no, I just like meeting person in person, that's your choice. But for me, I like to do it in an efficient way. So I can manage my time and I can do more, and this is the thing. But one other thing I want to tell you about, if you are building a personal branding, you need to have your own mission, vision, and action as well too. A junkie cannot build a personal brand. And I believe that none of you are junkies here. All of them have some core values, mission, and action into it as well too. So what it matters is about how you put it on into it. So I'm gonna get more detail into that as well too, and later on my sponge. So it's about, these are the platform is there. Another one you could do offline as well too. See, it's gonna be very much depend on you. So this is the thing I'm gonna answer to you right now in this slide too. You gotta pick the thing what you're really good at it. If you are thinking that you are amazing talking in person and you have an amazing amount of time, do it. If you think that if you are great at writing, write the contents. Don't be in front of the camera. Because you are really good at writing. And then have someone to make the video for you. Another thing is about, you are great at speaking long content. You can make 15 to 20 minute talks. Great, so then YouTube is important. And or if you think that, oh, you are great at writing contents, which is like small blocks, then you can focus about LinkedIn as well, or you can take that YouTube as well too. So you start always about what you're really good at it, and then you focus into that one as well too. But it doesn't mean that when you're building a personal branding, it's gonna be 100% digital, or it's gonna be 100% offline. You need to have a right balance. Because it's gonna be very much depending on your life. If you are a CEO or director of a company, or CEO of a company, you probably don't have a lot of time to go to the other events. So what are you gonna do? You're gonna maximum use of your time, which you can put it onto it. At the same time, if you're a student, you probably have a lot of time in your time. So probably you could think about how you're gonna segment the hours for building your personal brand. Or if you're already young professionals, you can think about how many time you can put on for digital and offline too. And then, more importantly, this is the beautiful life. You don't just stick into one strategy with the one segmentation. It's more you go forward, more you adjust your hours and your segmentation between all of this thing too. So that is why I'm saying this one. If you say that all this platform, which is great, I would say that LinkedIn is one of the best ones if you're building personal branding. Because why? Because this platform still has the most amount of organic reach compared to anyone else. But again, I'm gonna tell you, it depends on what you're really good at it.
There is one thing that you really need to think about. Before doing anything, you need to stop and think about what are you good at?
Yes.
Each of us, we should do a SWOT analysis of ourselves.
Yeah.
And nobody does that.
Yeah. Many other people are unfortunately not doing this one. So that's why I'm saying that, please, figure out first, SWOT analysis is one of the way, figure out what you're really good at it. And then you pick the right platform. And then if you don't have to have a time to cover all the platform, but you really want to do other platform, get someone help you to do the other platform. Or if you think that you cannot even have someone because you don't have opportunity or you don't have capacity, so then just stay there from that platform which you're really good at it for right now. And then look for how you can expand to other platforms. So, but here is the point. When you want to build a particular content, these are the three things. Number one, you gotta be honest. There will be always someone who is better than you, what you're doing. Always there will be someone. If you're a marketer, there will be someone better. Even like the talk I'm giving right now, this in-personal branding, there will be someone who can give a better talk than me as well too. So what it matters is about what you know, bring the best version of your knowing by being honest and put into your content. It's matter most. If you are talking about particular stories of your life or of your success, focus into that one and be genuinely and share that one. If it's a success stories or if it's a failure stories, doesn't matter. Put it on. So this is the way I want to talk about this one. So when we start to make contents, a lot of people do that. They start to, whoa, what's the trend going on? What's the other people talking about it? What's the other people getting a lot of like and views? What's the other thing going on? Stories are not outside. Stories are inside of you. Because what you're gonna do is you're gonna document your journey of your life. Rather than you pretending and collecting the story from other people, you have your own journey. If you're building a product, that's your journey. It takes 1, 2, 3 years. If you're a GM, your journey as a GM is your journey. What you do your regular day. If you're a marketer, what you're doing in a month. If you're building your own career, if you're a junior executive right now, how you do this journey? How are you gonna build, what is the new thing you are learning into it? What are the new things you're trying to do? What is the company interview you went and had miserable failure? So this is the way when you talk about the journey, you have to talk about your success, and you're gonna talk about your stories, I mean, which is failure, and also you're gonna talk about what you accomplish as well too. So if you could focus on these three, you'll have a great documentation of your journey. So the second point is be authentic. That's why it's coming to play. Be authentic when you talk about it. And the last one is about be passionate. Because this is where it's very important. Because I tell about a lot of people just simply give up because they just lose their motivation. And in the deep dive inside of you, how passionate you are to build this thing for yourself, because which is a winning game for you in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years of time, not just 6 months, not about 3 months. Some people get lucky because they're so good in their content in a very early stage, but most of the time it takes years of time to build the right personal brand. So being a passionate into it and really keep doing it matter the most here. So these are the three things you need to look into it. So now let me jump into it. So when you want to build a personal branding, you need to stop. First, let's just do it. And then you need to think about what you started to, what are you really good at it, and you pick the right platform. I want to tell you on this one. You're gonna be suck if you're not starting it. Everybody is suck in first 50 to 100 posts. If you start a video blog, first 50 to 100 video you're gonna create are gonna be suck. But that will be gonna be a platform for you to create great content after that. If you're right, start writing, plus 50 writing articles will be terrible for you. And then you can build on top of it. And then it's gonna be your journey to see that which platform is perfect for you, which the way you're writing into it. But if you already lived a life 22 or 50 years, like Pedro was mentioning about, doing a SWOT analysis and figure out what you're really good at. You love speaking, you love meeting people, or you love writing. But this is the thing is very important. 10 years ago, the email marketing, the other thing like an example, SEO was the day, right? But now those all become like a radio right now. This doesn't work anymore. Still works. If you send an email 10 years ago, email marketing with 100 people with a good list, that we used to be like 80 to 90% open rate. But now that is like 10 to 15. If you're good at it, 30, I mean, wow, 30% open rate. That's amazing already. You could stick to those old ways of doing reaching people, or you can use this new platform what I've just mentioned about it, because these are the things used to be much better because you used to have less content, but now more content coming into it. So day by day, it's getting worse and organic reach is going down, but still, it's much better than those traditional SEO and email marketing. So that's coming to the second thing, is about stay on your lane. If you're really good at it, focus on that one and carry on building into that one as well too. And this is mattermost. If you start doing this one, post daily. If you pick up a particular post, particular platform, try to post daily, or at least 2 to 3 in a week. Sometimes it's difficult for many people to come on and then really do a daily post. I do a lot of posts actually. But for the beginners, it could be very difficult to come up with so many contents and put it on. So try to make 2 to 3 posts in your particular platform. I mean, I'm not talking about another post about, it's about, which is actually putting into about a dog, cat, or baby face photo, but actually a real vision, action missions content you put on.